What's up, boys and girls? This week, I want to talk a little bit about real estate foreclosures and not buying real estate foreclosures. I want to debunk a few myths about real estate foreclosures. So if you are a homeowner who might be going through foreclosure or are currently going through foreclosure, well, then this video is for you. Because in this video, I'm going to debunk 7 myths that I found are pretty common when it comes to foreclosures. So if you're watching this video right now, you're probably thinking all of these negative things like, the bank wants to take my home and I'm gonna come home and all of my content is gonna be on the front yard. Well, guess what? Stick around and make it to the end of this video because I'm pretty sure by the end of this video, you will feel a little bit better about your given situation. But before we dive into all of that, I'm Chris Nelson with Genstone Realty, and this channel is all about real estate advice, tips, and tech. So if any of that excites you, you're in the right place. But do me a favor, drop that comment, give me a thumbs up, consider subscribing, and mash that bell so that you're notified of my future content. So the very first myth that I want to debunk is the fact that the banks actually want to foreclose on your home. Let me make this very clear. The banks do not want to foreclose on your home. And if anything, they want the complete opposite. It is very expensive for a bank to foreclose on a home. And they know that going through the foreclosure process usually is going to result in them taking back a product, your home, in a condition a lot less than they'd like to have it in. Because usually when there's a foreclosure, there is a legal process in which the borrower and the bank or servicer have to go through. And a lot of the times those properties aren't being maintained, subsequently leaving the bank with an ugly property. So let me make it clear that the banks would rather work with you because not only is it beneficial to them, but it's beneficial to you to help you avoid a foreclosure. So please get out of your mind that the banks want your home because banks are not in the business to own homes. Banks are in the business to be banks, issue loans, and collect fees on servicing. The second myth is that you can't refinance if you are in foreclosure. Now, refinancing if you are in foreclosure may be a lot more difficult, or you may have a lot less options in front of you, but let's make it clear. You can definitely refinance if your loan is in foreclosure. Now, if your loan is in foreclosure and you're the borrower, chances are your credit has been beat up a little bit and you're probably not the candidate who they would just want to refinance with. But if you have a significant other or a family friend or someone who is willing to help you by co-signing on a loan, that is one way you could refinance your home. Or believe it or not, if you have enough equity in your home where the bank looks at it as a marginal or limited risk to refinance your home, well, believe it or not, you may be able to do that as well. The key thing to keep in mind when it comes to refinancing your loan is that you're going to have to show the bank that you have the ability to repay that debt. So if they restructure the debt, you have the ability to go ahead and maintain those payments moving forward, which, well, makes you a pretty good candidate for a refinance. Myth number three. Myth number three is that you actually can stop a foreclosure even after it has started. A lot of borrowers think that once the foreclosure process has started, there isn't anything that they can do, and now they're in this wild ride up until the day the property is taken back from them. Now, keep in mind, this is not the case. A foreclosure is a legal matter between the servicer and the borrower, and it is possible for you to stop the foreclosure process. Now, you will need to have a legitimate reason for the foreclosure process to be stopped, such as you've come to an agreement with your servicer where you're going to modify the loan and get back on track with your payments. Or you can negotiate with the servicer to stop the foreclosure so that maybe you can get a few paychecks under your belt if you are back and employed. Or maybe you came into some money which can help you rectify that delinquent balance, which again will stop the foreclosure process. So foreclosures can be stopped, but you will need a reason and or means, cash, for that servicer to go ahead and stop the foreclosure process. Myth number four. Although a foreclosure will wreak havoc on your credit score, It is not forever. Now, having a foreclosure on your credit report is one of the most damaging things that you can have on your credit overall. The same thing applies to car repossessions. These things will drop your credit score drastically and will remain on your credit for quite some time. Now, don't hold me to this, but on average, a foreclosure will stay on your credit for about 7 years. Now, although that is a lengthy time, that doesn't mean that you will never be able to buy a home again because, well, the foreclosure will come off of your credit report at some point. So as long as you are doing your best to rebuild your credit and show creditors that you have the ability and the responsibility to maintain payments, you at some point again could qualify for a mortgage and own another home at some point. Which brings me to myth number 5, the fact that you won't be able to get any additional credit in your name. Now again, this foreclosure is gonna stay on your credit for quite some time, but that doesn't mean that you won't be able to apply for credit. As time progresses and other creditors are seeing that you are doing what you can to maintain the other established pieces of credit that you have, you will be able to qualify for other pieces of credit, such as other credit cards, car loans, and so forth. Now, the terms that you get on future credit post a foreclosure might not be the most attractive terms, but keep in mind that you need to show these creditors that you are worthy of having credit. And because of that, they're going to charge you and they're going to make it a little bit painful up front, but in the long run, do what you can to maintain those relationships, make those payments, keep your balances down, and over time, you will see that the opportunity for you to obtain new pieces of credit will become easier and easier. Which brings me to myth number 6. And myth number 6 is that a foreclosure is always a bad thing. A foreclosure is not always a bad thing, and as a matter of fact, there is something that is referred to as a strategic default. Now, before we get into that, I will say that I'm an advocate of doing anything and everything you possibly can before you just step away from a property and let the servicer foreclose on it. If you are in foreclosure, there are things that you can do, such as try to do a short sale or even a deed in lieu when you're giving the property back to the servicer. If you have to do a strategic default, it may not necessarily be a bad move. If you owe $300,000 on a home that is only worth $200,000 because of either the market or the condition, it doesn't make sense for you to go into your pocket and put $100,000 into that property to get it back to fair market value. Most people don't have the means of doing that. And if you did, you have to ask yourself, is it financially wise for you to do so? And when you're in these situations, this is where you may want to consider a strategic default. And as I mentioned, you can do a short sale or a deed in lieu, but if either of those don't work, well, then maybe letting the servicer foreclose on the property and dealing with the foreclosure, knowing that it is going to impact your credit, and there could be some taxation on that debt as well. That's a whole nother topic, but this is something that many people consider and isn't always a bad thing. And last but not least, myth number 7, and this is probably my favorite because this is a question or a thought that I am presented with often when I'm working with people who are in the foreclosure status or being foreclosed on. And that myth is that you will not come home to find all of your content out on the street. As a matter of fact, there was a movie that was put out a few years ago, and the thing that pained me the most was that they were not painting an accurate picture on what happens to people who are going through a foreclosure process. And to be transparent, back in about 2008, I also was going through a foreclosure situation and it was beating me up. I became very passionate about it, which is why I try to be a resource now. But in the back of my mind, I was always worried about pulling up to the house and there being a lock on my door and all my content being out on the street. Let me tell you that things do happen and there are situations where things slip through the cracks, but that is not the case. You will not come home to a padlock on your door and your content outside. In Pennsylvania and in other states throughout the country, there are laws in place that prevent that type of behavior. I promise you that it is in no one's intention to just show up to your property and lock you out of your personal belongings or your home. As a matter of fact, banks do everything that they possibly can to communicate with you to make sure that these situations don't happen. But if you are avoiding the bank and you're not taking phone calls, and if someone knocks on your door to confirm whether or not that home is occupied, do yourself a favor and use your voice and let them know that you are residing in that home, because servicers also reserve the right to protect a property in which they find abandoned. So make sure that it's not labeled abandoned and you should be fine. So there you have it. There are 7 foreclosure myths debunked. Hopefully this video will alleviate a little bit of stress. And if you're going through foreclosure or soon to be going through foreclosure or have any questions about the foreclosure process, keep in mind that I'm here to be of value to you. With all of that being said, check in next week for the very next Just the Tip Tuesday with Chris. Until then, take care.